Okay, hello everybody. Welcome to this class for Environmental Engineering Laboratory. Today we're going to work on Lab 2D, which is measuring the residual disinfectant in the distribution system for the drinking water in the city. No? It is important to have some residual disinfectant in the water that's not being used because some opportunistic pathogens might grow and they could be harmful, specifically for immunocompromised people. Okay? So we don't want them to get sick. We need to determine how much residual is there, and if there is not enough residual, we have to flush the water right to get some fresh water in it. Okay, and unfortunately for you, we are going to look back at basic chemistry. I know it's been a while, but I'm pretty sure you're going to manage to remember the stuff. And we're also going to use calculus, so don't be too scared. It's basic calculus. It's not too difficult. But if you have any questions about basic chemistry or calculus, please send me an email, come to my office hours, or we can talk after class, okay? However you feel comfortable. Alright, so let's dive into it. For chlorine concentration, remember that we have to define the rate of reaction. No? The rate of reaction is defined as a kinetic constant times the concentration of the compound that I'm interested in, and this is also defined as the change of the concentration over time, right? And since the residual disinfectant is disappearing over time, this is going to have a negative sign, okay? If it would be a reaction where the product is being generated, it would have a positive sign. Now I'm going to put together these two concepts, right? And here's where the calculus comes in, because I have a differential that I want to get rid of. And for doing that, I need to integrate this equation, right? So I'm going to rearrange the terms. Remember, if you have any questions, please let me know. Come to office hours. Don't be afraid to ask questions, okay? So I'm going to arrange this as the differential of the concentration over the concentration. I'm just putting the similar terms together. And then I'm going to have this done like minus the kinetic constant times the time differential, okay? Now that I have the terms in the same side, I'm going to integrate this to get rid of the differential, right? And the two limits or the two boundaries that I'm interested in are the concentration at time zero. It means when the water leaves the treating plant, the treatment plant, and the concentration at a certain time t, where I'm interested if there is enough residual disinfectant to kill those pathogens. If not, I have to flush the water, right? Same, time zero when the water leaves the treatment plant, time t when I know if there is enough residual, okay? And now I'm going to integrate this. Does any of you remember what is the integral of 1 over x? Instead of x, I'm just using the concentration. Does anybody remember? Yep, that's right. The integral of 1 over the concentration would be the natural logarithm of the concentration. Perfect. And that's all the calculus that we need. So as you can see, very straightforward. Okay? We're going to evaluate this between the two limits that we have when the water leaves the plant, and our time t. And the same is going to happen in the other side. We're going to have minus kt, and we're going to evaluate between time 0 and time t. Luckily for us, time 0 goes to 0, so we don't have to account for it. Now, after that, I assess this integral between the two limits, I'm going to rearrange the equation in a way that's useful for me. I mean, useful for you, because it's going to make your lives easier. And I'm going to come up with this equation right here, which is the natural logarithm of the concentration at any time t that I am interested to know. It's going to be equal to minus the kinetic constant times the time and plus the natural logarithm of the initial concentration when it leaves the water treatment plant. Okay? I know there's a lot of logarithms. They are not too friendly with you, but for us it's good, because this equation has the shape of a straight line. There you go. In the y-axis, I have the natural logarithm of the concentration. I have that the slope of this straight line is going to correspond to the kinetic constant, which is what we need to determine if there will be enough residual disinfectant in our pipes. No? And since this is a line, we can plot this. We can take different readings of the concentration of the disinfectant, and we can plot this into Excel, which is very helpful for us. And we're going to plot the time on x, right? And on the y-axis, we're going to plot the natural logarithm of the concentration that we're going to measure during this laboratory. Okay? If this model works, we're going to have a straight line. And for that straight line, the slope is going to be the kinetic constant. But remember, this is only for first order reactions, right? Remember that this had a first order reaction. We can have order 0, we can have order 2, we can have order 1.5, plenty of orders. But for our purposes, we're just going to consider first order, okay? I hope this is very helpful. I don't know if you have any questions, right? Remember that we're going to measure the disinfectant concentration over time. So you guys are going to have to report the kinetic constant for different orders, no? Are there any questions? If not, we're done for today. Don't forget to go to office hours and reach out to me if you have any questions, please.